Hi everyone, my name is Nihal of Class 9. Today I am going to explain about the few important information about the Indian Constituent Assembly. First, history of the Indian Constituent Assembly. The idea of the Indian Constituent Assembly was first given by M.N. Roy in 1934. In 1935, the demand was taken up by Congress Party as its own official demand. In 1940, the British government accepts this in the August offer. In 1946, in the cabinet, Mr. Vipan says that there should be election for all Constituent Assembly members in a method of single transferable vote of proportional representation. The main aim or the main purpose of the Indian Constituent Assembly is to write the Indian Constitution for the newly independent India. Composition of the Indian Constituent Assembly. First, initially, there were 389 members in the Constituent Assembly. After the partition, some of the members went to Pakistan and it became 299. Out of 299, 229 are of British provinces. Other 70 members are nominated from the princely states. Dr. Satyidananda Sinha was first appointed as the temporary president of the Indian Constituent Assembly. After that, Dr. Babu Rajendra Prasad was elected as the permanent president of the Indian Constituent Assembly, and H.C. Mukherjee and T.T. Krishnamachari was the vice president. And M.N. Roy was the legal advisor of the Indian Constituent Assembly. Committees of the Indian Constituent Assembly. The first committee was Drafting Committee. Drafting Committee will come under Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. Dr. B.R. Ambedkar was a jurist, lawyer, economist and social reformer. And he is the chief architect of the Indian Constitution and is the father and founder of the Indian Republic. Second committee is Union Constitution Committee, Union Powers Committee and States Committee will come under Jawaharlal Nehru. Jawaharlal Nehru is the Indian independence activist and subsequently he became the first Prime Minister of India. And third committee is Steering Committee and Rules and Regulation Committee will come under Dr. Babu Rajendra Prasad. Dr. Babu Rajendra Prasad was an Indian independence activist and subsequently he also became the first President of India. And the fourth committee is Provincial Constitution Committee will come under Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel. Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel is also known as Sardar Patel and for his work he is also known as Iron Man of India. And his main role after the partition was he did the integration of more 500 princely states into the Union of India. And the fifth committee was the Special Committee to Examine the Drafting Committee. It was led by Alladi Krishnaswamy Iyer. Alladi Krishnaswamy Iyer was an Indian lawyer and he was also the member of Indian Constituent Assembly. Key facts of Indian Constitution. The first meeting of Indian Constituent Assembly was first held in 9th December 1946. Our national flag was adopted by us in 22nd July 1947 and there was no role played by Muslim League in our Constituent Assembly. In making of Indian Constituent Assembly. Our national anthem Janagana Mana was adopted by us in 1950, January 24th, 2 days before of Republic Day, 2 days early of Republic Day. The Constituent Assembly had spent 2 years, 11 months, 18 days to write the Indian Constitution and they have travelled across 50 countries and they have spent 64 lakhs to frame the Indian Constitution. The final document has 22 parts, 395 articles and 8 schedules. And it was adopted by us in November 26, 1949 and it came to enforcement in 1950, January 26th. As Mahatma Gandhiji said, I regard Indian Constitution as the substitute of Satyagraha. It is constructive Satyagraha. This shows the importance of Constituent Assembly in the making of the Indian Constitution. Thank you. Have a nice day.